Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. This month on Space News, we reported on a recent study that confirms electrostatic dust transportation occurs on airless bodies in space, including comets, asteroids, and moons. The NASA-funded research suggested that electrostatic effects could explain a number of mysterious discoveries, including the emission of fluffy dust particles from the nucleus of comet 67P, the formation of weird dust configurations on 67P and the asteroid Eros, and the surprisingly smooth surface of Saturn's moon Atlas. The investigators observed electrostatic effects in the laboratory when dust was exposed both to UV radiation and to plasma. Nevertheless, few astronomers today consider electrical effects on comets or asteroids when attempting to explain the still mysterious behaviors of these bodies. This may be evidenced in recently published scientific research into a newly discovered active asteroid called P2016G1. The object has been studied in part to try to answer an ongoing question. Should asteroids that show comet-like activity be categorized as main belt comets? The team observed that asteroid P2016G1 became active 350 days before perihelion, or its closest approach to the Sun. Over a period of 24 days, the asteroid emitted a total dust mass of at least 17,000 tons. The only hypotheses the scientists have considered are impacts, thermal fracturing, rotational instabilities, and sublimating ices. The explanation the team has settled on is that an impact partially destroyed the body, causing the subsequent emissions of dust. Their paper states, "We speculate that this dust ejection could be associated to an impact and that the subsequent modeled activity is due to the asteroid partial or total disruption. The impact itself had produced the ejection of some 240 tons of dust." The team noted that, quote, "A conspicuous westward feature in the head of the comet-like object indicates that a significant fraction of the dust was ejected along a privileged direction right at the beginning of the event." Let us also consider the case of P2013P5, an asteroid which was recently reclassified as a main belt comet. The asteroid astonished scientists around the world when it suddenly displayed six comet-like tails. One scientist said at the time, "It's hard to believe we're looking at an asteroid." The mystery for astronomers was apparent. How can a rocky asteroid grow and maintain highly collimated jets of material, forming the comet tails? An ad hoc theory arose, to the effect that the asteroid suddenly began spinning faster for some reason, possibly because, as one scientist suggested, pressure from sunlight exerted a torque on the body. This change in the asteroid's spin rate may have caused material to, quote, "avalanche downslope towards the equator and maybe shatter and fall off, eventually drifting into space to make a tail." It was then suggested that radiation pressure stretched and confined the dust into the comet tails. If mainstream astronomy is now recognizing electrostatic dust transportation on airless bodies in space, then why is this not among the hypotheses considered for an asteroid or comet's dust emission? Traditionally, astronomers have only envisioned minor electrostatic effects on asteroids and comet nuclei due to direct surface exposure to solar radiation and the solar wind. But for decades, surprising discoveries in the study of both comets and asteroids have demanded new theoretical pathways. Mysterious comet-like behaviors from asteroids are not a mystery if comets and asteroids are not as different as astronomers have long believed. In the Electric Universe theory, as developed by Wal Thornhill, asteroids, comets, and meteoroids were all born in interplanetary electrical events. Their distinctive orbital groupings and spectral features point to separate catastrophic events and to different planetary bodies involved in different phases of solar system history. Comet activity, including the production of the familiar coma and tail, are not the result of sublimating ices due to solar warming. A long-standing mystery is why comets sometimes flare or even explode at vast distances from the Sun, much too far to explain through solar warming. This will happen when a comet experiences a sudden voltage spike when traveling through varying regions of electrical potential. One such source of a voltage spike is solar flares, a subject of growing scientific interest. at the recent Thunderbolts conference in Phoenix, Arizona, the Russian scientist Dr. Supan Ibidov proposed that a capacitor-like breakdown occurs between a comet's charged subsurface and a differently charged surface due to arriving protons from the sun. In the electric universe theory of Wall Thornhill, any body moving on an elliptical orbit within the sun's weak electric field can exhibit comet-like electrical discharge activity, though of course on a much smaller scale. Such behavior may have been recently witnessed when astronomers observed giant plumes jetting from the surface of Mars. Scientists recently reported the completely unexpected discovery that a coronal mass ejection hit Mars immediately before the plume was first spotted. A new scientist report on the discovery states, "One possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher, but it's not clear how the effect would be big." A similar phenomenon may have been witnessed on the aforementioned asteroid, P2016G1. Just as the Martian plumes were not caused by an impact, the asteroid's emission of dust, which initially ejected along a preferential direction, was most likely caused by an electrical discharge. Investigating scientists should explore the changes in the asteroid's plasma environment, such as the asteroid's proximity to a planet's magnetotail. Just as the Earth's magnetotail has been found to create regular electrostatic dust storms on the Moon. With each new discovery, it seems that the behaviors of comets, asteroids, and all bodies within our sun's domain provide greater and greater affirmation that we live in an electric universe. For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.